So you did it. You clicked. You want to know the gossip. You want to know the tea. You want to know the nitty-gritty details. Well, here's the damn truth. Hey, everybody. It's Matt. It is the Drama King back here on the old YouTube chisel. That's Carney for channel. And you want to know the true details of what happened on that infamous night at Payback 2016 when Enzo Amore got injured in both of our debut pay-per-view matches for me and Simon, the Vaudevillains, and Enzo and Cass. Now, a lot of stories have circulated around what exactly happened, how it happened, not the least of which is fueled because of the infamous Simon Gotch, Seth Lesser's YouTube interview, which has now gone viral and is recommended on almost every channel, where he talks about his dislike for Enzo Amore as a pro wrestler. This I can confirm. Ladies and gentlemen, it is no secret, Simon and Enzo did not get along. That was not exactly Simon's idea of what a pro wrestler should be. He thought he was all flash, no substance. So these two did not get along outside of the ring. Enzo wasn't fond of Gotch. Gotch wasn't fond of Enzo. That being said, I will say this. Having worked with them tens upon tens, maybe hundreds of times throughout NXT and WWE, not once did I see either one of them try to take an unnecessary shot at the other in the confines of the professional wrestling ring. So what happened on that night? A lot of people say, oh, Enzo's an idiot and doesn't know how to wrestle and he knocked himself out. Or they say, Simon hated Enzo, so he threw him as hard as he could and made Enzo knock himself out. You want to know the real truth? I got the details. It's pro wrestling. An accident happened. I wasn't the one in there, so I can't tell you how hard Simon shot Enzo off. I can't tell you the kind of steps Enzo was taking when he ran to the ropes. I can tell you we have done that cutoff. We had done that move, that exact setup, several times on house shows before. Enzo has taken it, Simon has given it. Accidents happen. Sometimes a move you've done a million times, you take one wrong step, something is off. This is slightly different than it was the last time, and everything changes. This is a high-risk business. And that night, something terrible happened. An awful, awful accident happened to a professional who had done it many times before. It's one of those things. I will not sugarcoat anything about how those two felt about each other outside of the ring. There is no denying that, and you can see Seth's interviews and all the other evidence to that fact. But I can attest to that both of these guys, while polar opposites as people and performers, when that bell rang, did the best we could, put that crap aside, and tried to make the best of the situation. I'm not going to speak about what happened in the fallout of that between the two of them. Again, as you know, they clearly didn't like each other, and you know there were things that were said and done that probably didn't help further that relationship after that happened. But what I can, all I can speak to is that those two performers did not go out there to hurt either one of them anytime we stepped in the ring. That's the truth, folks. That's what happened. That is the true story of what happened at Payback 2016.